Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Kovilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the solution and discussion on the gate question paper in Mechanical Engineering subjects. And this is lecture number 35. We are going to solve few more problems on the conduction heat transfer. In the earlier lecture also, we discussed the conduction heat transfer. So, we will continue with the conduction heat transfer. The first question from 1992 question paper. Two rods, one of length L and other of length 2L are made of the same material and have the same diameter. The two ends of the longer rod is maintained at 100 degrees Celsius. One end of the shorter rod is maintained at 100 degrees Celsius and other end is insulated. Both rods are exposed to the same environment, 40 degrees Celsius. The temperature at the insulated end is measured to be 55 degrees Celsius. The temperature at the midpoint of the longer rod would be, so we have four options, 40, 50, 55 and 100 degrees Celsius. So the correct answer is 55 degrees Celsius. So we will see how in the next slide. So first we see the insulated, the short rod, smaller length of length equal to L, one end is 100 degrees Celsius, other end is insulated, so the temperature here is 55 degrees Celsius and the fin is, the rod is exposed to the environment at 40 degrees Celsius. So here it is 55 degrees Celsius. Now look at the longer rod of length 2L. Both the ends are maintained at 100 degrees Celsius and here again the surrounding temperature is 40 degrees Celsius. So the temperature profile, temperature profile for the longer rod, so between the two ends, so the temperature here is 100 degrees Celsius and the from both the end the convection is taking place and the temperature here will be the minimum. So at the center where length L, at the midpoint where length equal to L meter, the temperature difference is minimum. So this is the minimum point where the dt by dx equal to 0. The differentiation with respect dt, differentiation of temperature with respect to position equal to 0 at the x equal to L, at the midpoint of the longer rod. So when dt by dx equal to 0, so therefore the temperature at x equal to x at x equal to L for the longer rod is also 55 degrees Celsius, because so here we have insulated end dt by dx equal to 0. So this is resembling. So here for insulated rod dt by dx equal to 0, here for the longer rod at the midpoint dt by dx equal to 0, so the temperature is going to be 55 degrees Celsius. That is the answer. The next question from 2004 question paper, a spherical thermocouple junction of diameter 0.706 millimeter is to be used for the measurement of temperature of the gas stream. The convective heat transfer coefficient on the bead surface is 400 watts per meter square Kelvin. The thermophysical properties of the thermocouple material are thermal conductivity 20 watts per meter Kelvin, specific heat 400 joules per kilogram Kelvin, density 8500 kilograms per meter cube. If the thermocouple initially at 30 degrees Celsius is placed in a hot steam at 300 degrees Celsius, the time taken for the bead to reach 298 degrees Celsius is, we have four options, 2.35 seconds, 4.9 seconds, 14.7 seconds, 29.4 seconds. The correct answer is 4.9 seconds. So we will see how in the next slide. So given data, we write down the given data, diameter, heat transfer coefficient, thermal conductivity, specific heat, density, initial temperature 30 degrees Celsius, gas temperature 300 degrees Celsius and the temperature of the temperature 298, the bead temperature after some time. So we have to calculate the time taken to reach 298 degrees Celsius. So the characteristic length for the sphere LC, so LC equal to V by A. So, substituting volume and the surface area, this will be d by 6. So, d by 6 equal to 0.706 divided by 6, which is 0.1177 millimeter. So, the Biot number you have to calculate, Biot number is HLC by K. For the lumped parameter method, Biot number we have to calculate. So substituting 400 into 0.117 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 20 equal to 0.0023. So the Biot number is less than 0.1. So we may apply the lumped parameter method. So for lumped parameter method, so in the lumped parameter method, the temperature distribution T minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity. TO is the base temperature, T is the temperature, the given temperature, T infinity is the fluid's temperature, is equal to exponential of minus HA by rho VC into T. So it is exponential of, you take A to the denominator, so V by A equal to LC. So H by rho LC C into T. So substituting all the numerical values, 298 minus 300 divided by 30 minus 300 equal to exponential of, substituting here minus 400 by 8500 into 0.1177 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 400 into T equal to, so the value 298 minus 300 divided by 30 by 300 equal to 7.407 in 10 power minus 3. So we have to take the logarithm. So taking logarithm on both sides, that will give minus of 400 by 8500, the value in the bracket. So into 0.1177 10 power minus 3 into 400 T equal to logarithmic of this value, which is minus 4.905. So calculating T equal to 4.905 seconds. So that is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2005 question paper. A small copper ball of 5 mm diameter at 500 Kelvin is dropped into an oil bath whose temperature is 300 Kelvin. Thermal conductivity of copper is 400 watts per meter Kelvin. Its density is 9000 kilogram per meter cube and its specific heat is 385 joules per kilogram Kelvin. If the heat transfer coefficient is 250 watts per meter square Kelvin and lumped analysis is assumed to be valid, rate of fall of temperature of the ball at the beginning of the cooling will be, the rate of fall of the ball, temperature of the ball at the beginning of the cooling will be equal to 8.7 Kelvin per second, 13.9 Kelvin per second, 17.3 Kelvin per second and so 27.7 Kelvin per second. So we have to calculate the rate of decrease in temperature in the ball at the beginning of the cooling rate, where T equal to 0. So the answer is 17.3 second Kelvins per second. So we will see how in the next slide. So we write down the given data. So diameter, heat transfer coefficient, thermal conductivity, specific heat, density, initial temperature and the fluid temperature. We write all the given properties, given parameters. Then heat loss by the copper ball equal to heat gain by the fluid. That is the principle for convection, I mean the heat transfer process. So unsteady state heat transfer. So heat loss by the ball equal to minus MC into dou T by dou T. It's equal to heat gain by the fluid equal to HA into TO minus T infinity. So the M equal to rho into V. So mass equal to rho into V. So rho is the density, V is the volume of the material, C is the specific heat divided by HA into dou T by dou T equal to TO minus T infinity. So we have LC equal to V by A equal to R by 3, which is D by 6 for a spherical ball, copper ball. So substituting rho C by H into D by 6 into dou T equal to TO minus T infinity. So substituting all the values, minus 9000 into 385 divided by 250 into diameter is 5 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 6 into dou T equal to 500 minus 300. So calculating, left hand side is minus 11.55 dou T equal to 200. So the change in temperature with respect to time. So dou T at the beginning, so this is equal to minus 17.31, that is equal to 17.31 because the heat is lost by the ball. So that is why we have a negative sign. So the answer is 17.31 Kelvin per second. Next question from 2010 question paper. A fin has 5 millimeter diameter and 100 millimeter long. The thermal conductivity of the fin material is 400 watts per meter Kelvin. One end of the fin is maintained at 130 degrees Celsius and its remaining surface is exposed to the ambient at 30 degrees Celsius. If the convective heat transfer coefficient is 40 watts per meter square Kelvin, the heat loss from the fin. So we have to calculate the heat loss. So we have four options here, 0.08, 5, 7 and 7.8 watt. So the correct answer is 5 watts. So we will see how in the next slide. So we write down the given data. It is a pin fin. So we have a diameter 5 millimeter, length equal to 100 millimeter. So K thermal conductivity 400. So initial temperature, base temperature is 130 degrees Celsius, fluid temperature is 30 degrees Celsius, and heat transfer coefficient is 40 watts per meter square Kelvin. So we have to calculate the parameter area pi by 4 d square. It is 1.9625 in 10 power minus 5 meter square. Perimeter equal to pi d, pi into 5 in 10 power minus 3 equal to 0.0157 meter. We have to calculate m, m equal to square root of hb by ka, which is square root of 40 into 0.0157. Divided by 400 into 1.9625 in 10 power minus 5 equal to 8.944. Then we have to calculate the heat transfer. So for the heat transfer, for end insulated, we have to assume end insulated. So this is TO minus T infinity tan HML into square root of HPKA. So substituting all the numerical values. So 130 minus 30 into tan H of M equal to 8.944 into L equal to 0.1. Into square root of HPKA, so calculating it is 5 watts. So amount of heat transfer from the fin equal to 5 watts. Next question from 2011 question paper. A spherical steel ball 12 millimeter diameter is initially at 100 Kelvin. It is slowly cooled in a surrounding at 300 Kelvin. The heat transfer coefficient between the steel ball and the surrounding is 5 watts per meter square Kelvin. The thermal conductivity of the steel is 20 watts per meter Kelvin. The temperature difference between the center and the surface of the steel ball is large because of conduction resistance is far high than the convective resistance. Large because the conduction resistance is far less than the convective resistance. Small because the conduction resistance is far high than the convective resistance. Small because the conduction resistance is far less than the convective resistance. So which is correct? The four statements are given. So which is correct? So it is we just calculate the lumped parameter method. So we calculate the Biot number and verify if the Biot number is less than 0.1. So we come to a conclusion. So the correct answer is small. So the condition, look at the statement again. The temperature difference between the center and the surface of the steel ball is small because conduction resistance is far less than the convective resistance. So if this is the answer, then Biot number should be less than 0.1. So we will see in the next slide. So given data, so D equal to 12 millimeter, TO, the initial temperature 100 Kelvin, fluid temperature 300 Kelvin, H equal to heat transfer coefficient 5 watts per meter square Kelvin, K thermal conductivity 20. The characteristic length for the ball, it is a spherical system, D by 6, 12 by 6 equal to 2 millimeter, Biot number HLC by K equal to 5 into 2 in 10 power minus 3 divided by 20 equal to 5 in 10 power minus 4. So lumped parameter method is applicable. So when the lumped parameter method is applicable, for Biot number is less than 0.1, so internal conduction resistance is less than external convection resistance. That is what the answer. So it is small because internal conduction resistance is less than the external convection resistance. So when this is the condition, the internal conduction resistance, that is negligible. So for negligible, there is no temperature difference between the center and the surface of the ball. Next question from 2013 question paper. A steel ball of diameter 60 millimeter is initially in thermal equilibrium at 1030 degrees Celsius in a furnace. It is suddenly removed from the furnace and cooled in the ambient air at 30 degrees Celsius with convective heat transfer coefficient 20 watts per meter square Kelvin. The thermophysical properties of the steel are density 7800 kilogram per meter cube, thermal conductivity 40 watts per meter Kelvin and specific heat 600 joules per kilogram Kelvin. The time required in seconds to cool the steel ball in air from 1030 degrees Celsius to 430 degrees Celsius is, we have the time, four values, 519, 931, 1195, 2144 seconds. So the correct answer is 2144 seconds. So we will see how in the next slide. Here again we have to calculate the Biot number and apply the lumped parameter method to calculate the time. So write down the given data. So the all the parameter, read the problem statement carefully and write down the given data. The characteristic length for the steel ball, LC equal to D by 6, which is 0.06 divided by 6 equal to 0.01 meter. And Biot number is HLC by K equal to 20 into 0.01 divided by 40 equal to 0.005. So Biot number is less than 0.1, so we can apply the lumped parameter method. So the temperature distribution for the lumped parameter method, so this equation you have to remember. So T minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity. So T is the, TO is the initial temperature, T infinity is the fluid temperature, T is the given temperature of the steel ball. So the exponential of minus HA by rho VC into T equal to exponential of minus H. We take A to the denominator, so V by A equal to LC. So H by rho LC into C into T. So substituting all the numerical values, so 430 minus 30 divided by 1030 minus 30 equal to exponential of this value, minus 20 divided by 7800 into 0.01 into 600 into T. You take logarithm. So logarithm, when you take logarithm, exponential term is getting deleted. So minus of 20 divided by 7800 into 0.001 into 600 into T equal to logarithmic of 400 divided by 1000 equal to minus 0.9162. So cross multiplying, calculating the time, it is 2144.1 seconds. So this is the answer to the problem. Next question from 2016 question paper. A steel ball 10 mm diameter and 1000 Kelvin is required to be cooled to 350 degrees Celsius by immersing it in a water environment at 300 Kelvin. The convective heat transfer coefficient is 1000 watts per meter square Kelvin. Thermal conductivity of the steel is 40 watts per meter Kelvin. The time constant for the cooling process is 16 seconds. The time required to reach the final temperature is dash seconds. So time constant is given here. So from the time constant, we have to calculate the, using the time constant, we have to calculate the time, time required to reach the final temperature. The answer is 42.22 seconds. So we will see how in the next slide. So we write down the given data, all the data, read the problem and write down the given data. So time constant is given by Tc equal to 16 seconds. And the time constant Tc equal to rho Vc by H into As. So it is second to the power minus 1. The unit is second to the power minus 1. And the temperature distribution. So for lumped parameter method, temperature distribution T minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity equal to exponential of minus HCAS by rho VC. So 1 by HCAS by rho VC is the time constant. So this will be exponential of minus T by TC. So substituting all the values, 350 minus 300 divided by 1000 minus 300 equal to exponential of minus T by 16. So calculating, taking the logarithm, calculating time equal to 42.2249 seconds. So the time is 42.22 seconds. Next question from 2016 question paper. Two cylindrical shafts A and B at the same initial temperature are simultaneously placed in a furnace. The surface of the shaft remain at the furnace gas temperature at all times after they were introduced into the furnace. The temperature variation in axial direction of the shaft can be measured to be negligible. The data related to shaft A and shaft B given the following table. The temperature at the center line of the shaft A reaches 400 degrees Celsius after 2 hours. The time required for the center line of the shaft B to attain the 400 degrees Celsius is dash hours. We are given the parameter, diameter, shaft A 4.4 meter, shaft B 0.1 meter, thermal conductivity, shaft A 40 watts per meter Kelvin, shaft B 20 watts per meter Kelvin, volumetric heat capacity, 2 into 10 power 6 joules per meter cube Kelvin, and here for B, 2 into 10 power 7 joules per meter cube Kelvin. So the time required, so this is the unsteady state heat transfer problem, one dimensional unsteady state heat transfer for a cylindrical system. So for calculating time required for the center line to reach the temperature, we have to calculate the Fourier number. So the everything is the same. The parameters are same, so we have to, so the time calculator has 2.5 hours, so we will see how in the next slide. So the time for the center line temperature is to be calculated from the Fourier number. So for given information, Fourier number of slab shaft A is equal to Fourier number of shaft B. So for Fourier number is alpha T by rho square. So alpha T by rho square for A equal to alpha T by R square. So alpha T by R square for A equal to alpha T by R square for B. So alpha equal to K by rho C. So alpha is the thermal diffusivity, which is thermal conductivity divided by rho C. So substituting K by rho C into T by R square for on both sides. Substituting the parameter, so for A, we know all the values. 40 into 2 hours into 2 into 10 power 6 into 0.4 square. For B, 20 into T into 2 into 10 power 7 into 0.1 square for the B. So, time for B is not known. So, time equal to calculating from the given numerical numbers. So, the answer is 2.5 hours. So, the time is 2.5 hours. The next question from 2016 question paper. A long slender metallic rod of length L is used as a fin. As shown in the figure below, left end of the fin is kept at constant temperature TB. The fin loses heat by convection to the atmosphere, which is at temperature TA. So, TA is less than TB. Four options of temperature profile are shown. Identify the correct option. So, the temperature profile, it is linear. That is not correct. This is not correct. This is also not correct. The correct answer is, this is the correct answer. Y. So, the temperature distribution for a long infinite length, long rod, right? T minus TA divided by TB minus TA equal to e to the power minus mx. The temperature variation is in the exponential form. Temperature variation is in the exponential form, e to the power minus mx. The temperature profile, the correct temperature profile is option B. So, this is the correct temperature profile for a fin of infinite length. Next question from 2016 question paper, a cylindrical steel rod of 0.01 meter in diameter and 0.2 meter long is first heated to 750 degrees Celsius and then immersed in water in a water bath at 100 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient is 250 watts per meter square Kelvin. The density, specific heat and thermal conductivity of the steel are 7801 kilogram per meter cube, 473 joules per kilogram Kelvin. And 43 watts per meter Kelvin respectively. The time required for the rod to reach 300 degrees Celsius is dash seconds. Again, unsteady state lumped parameter method we have to apply. So, 42.43 seconds. So, we will see how in the next slide. So, write down the given data. So, all the information are written here. And we have to calculate the volume and the area. So, 1.57 10 power minus 5. And here, area, it is a shorter length. Look at the diameter and the length. So, the shorter length, the surface area equal to 2 into pi by 4 d square. So, this is the two end surfaces into pi dl. So, this is the lateral surface. So, pi dl is the lateral surface. 2 into pi by 4 d square is the end surface. So, area is 6.437 10 power minus 3 meter square. Then, time record. So, temperature distribution for the lumped parameter method T minus T infinity divided by TO minus T infinity equal to exponential of minus HCAS by rho VC into T. So, calculating, substituting numerical values, 300 minus 100 divided by 750 minus 100 equal to exponential of minus 250 into 6.437 10 power minus 3 divided by 7801 into 1.57 10 power minus 5 into 473 into T. So, taking the logarithm. So, taking logarithm minus of 250 value within the square, within the bracket equal to logarithmic of 200 by 650 equal to minus 1.1786. So, cross multiplying and calculating the time equal to 42.43 seconds. The next question from 2017 question paper, a metal ball of diameter 60 millimeter is initially at 220 degrees Celsius. The ball is suddenly cooled by an air jet of 20 degrees Celsius. The heat transfer coefficient is 200 watts per meter square Kelvin. The specific heat, thermal conductivity and density of the metal ball are 400 joules per kilogram Kelvin, 400 watts per meter Kelvin and 9000 kilogram per meter cube. The temperature in degrees Celsius after 90 seconds will be approximately. So, we have to calculate the temperature. So, we have four options. So, here again, it is unsteady state problem. We have to apply the lumped parameter method. The temperature is 141 degrees Celsius. So, we will see how. So, write down the given data. So, write down the given data. All the informations are written here. And the time is 90 seconds. We have to calculate the temperature. So, the characteristic length for the metal ball, LC equal to D by 6, 0.06 divided by 6 equal to 0.01 meter. Biot number is HLC by K, 2200 into 0.01 divided by 400 equal to 0.005. So, Biot number, lumped parameter is applicable. Biot number is less than 0.1. Then, we take the temperature distribution equation for the lumped parameter method t minus t infinity divided by to minus t infinity equal to exponential of minus ha by rho vc into t into the exponential of, you take a to the denominator, v by a equal to characteristic length lc, so h by rho lc into c into t, taking, so substituting numerical values, so t minus 20 divided by 200 minus 220 minus 20 equal to exponential of all these values. So time is also given, 90 seconds. So you calculate the exponent right hand side, it is 0.06065. So calculating the temperature, unknown temperature, T equal to 20 plus 0.06065 into 200 equal to 141.3 degrees Celsius. So which is 141. So the given value is 141 degrees Celsius. That is what the correct answer to the problem. The next question from 1989 question paper. The total efficiency eta T for a finned surface may be defined as the ratio of total heat transferred by the combined area of the fin and the exposed surface area to that total area A. So, the efficiency equal to the heat transfer by the fin, you have to consider the area, finned area and the total exposed area, if we are maintained at the base temperature TO degree Celsius. Assuming uniform heat transfer coefficient over the entire surface, derive an expression for the relationship between efficiency and the effectiveness of the fin. So, we have to calculate, we have to derive the efficiency, the relationship between effectiveness and efficiency of the fin. Fin efficiency, efficiency of the fin is given by heat transfer from the fin divided by heat transfer from the fin when the entire fin is at the base temperature. So, when the entire fin is at the base temperature, the heat transfer will be maximum. So, this efficiency of the fin is defined as Q fin, heat transfer by the fin divided by maximum possible heat transfer from the fin. Now, so we from here we calculate the heat transfer from the fin equal to efficiency of the fin into maximum possible heat transfer. So, the maximum possible heat transfer is HAS into TB minus T infinity. So, AS is the surface area of the fin, H is the heat transfer coefficient. Now, the fin effectiveness, epsilon equal to heat transfer with the fin divided by heat transfer without the fin. So, the ratio is heat transfer with the fin divided by heat transfer without fin. Now, heat transfer with the fin, we substitute from the previous equation. So, the heat transfer without fin equal to HAC. So, cross-sectional area, when there is no fin, what is the amount of heat transfer from the base surface? It is only cross-section of the fin. So, for detailed derivation discussion, you refer to the video lecture on the fins, first lecture on the fins, you may understand. So, you may understand with the diagram. So, HAC into TB minus T infinity. So, now substituting epsilon equal to Q fin divided by Q without fin. So, eta F into HAS into TB minus T infinity divided by HAC into TB minus T infinity. So, the relationship between effectiveness and the efficiency. Epsilon equal to eta F into AS by AC. AS is the surface area of the fin. AC is the cross-sectional area of the fin. So, effectiveness equal to efficiency of the fin into AS by AC. So, next question from 1990 question paper, an iron rod of thermal conductivity 41.5 watts per meter Kelvin of 15 millimeter diameter and 160 millimeter long extends out of a hot surface of temperature 150 degrees Celsius into environment at 36 degrees Celsius. The free end of the rod is insulated. If the film heat transfer coefficient is 25 watts per meter square Kelvin, calculate the rate of heat flowing out of the hot surface through the rod and the temperature at the end of the insulated end of the rod. So, this is short fin with the end insulation. We have to calculate the heat transfer from the short fin with the end insulation and the temperature at the insulated end. So, write down the given data. Thermal conductivity is 41.5 watts per meter Kelvin. Diameter is 0.015 meter. Length equal to 0.16 meter. Base temperature is 150 degrees Celsius. Fluid temperature is 36 degrees Celsius and heat transfer coefficient is 25 watts per meter square Kelvin. So, fin parameter for end insulated fin. So, area pi by 4 d square. So, 1.74 from 10 power of minus 4 meter square. Perimeter pi d. So, pi into 0.015 equal to 0.0471 meter. M equal to square root of HPKA. Substituting 25 into 0.0471. Divided by 41.5 into 1.744 in 10 power minus 4 equal to 12.76. Now, heat loss from the rod by the rod equal to TB minus T infinity tan HML into square root of HPKA. So, calculating 150 minus 36 into tan HML. So, M equal to 12.76, L equal to 0.16, into square root of HPKA. So 25 into 0.0471 into 41.5 into 1.744 into 10 power minus 4. So calculating, it is 10.175 watts. The amount of heat transfer equal to 10.175 watts. Temperature at x equal to L. So temperature distribution for ND insulated fin, TO minus T infinity divided by TB minus T infinity equal to cos H m L minus X divided by cos H m L. So x equal to L for end. So when you substitute x equal to L, L minus L equal to 0, cos H m L equal to cos H m 0 equal to 1. So 1 by cos H m L. So T minus 36 divided by 150 minus 36 equal to 1 by cos H 12.76 into 0.16 equal to 0.2553. So temperature equal to 65.1 degree Celsius. That is the answer. Next question from 2000 question paper. A wall is heated uniformly at a volumetric heat generation rate of 1 kilowatt per meter cube. The temperature distribution across 1 meter thick wall at a certain instant of time is given by T equal to A plus BX plus CX square, where A equal to 900, B equal to minus 200 degree Celsius per meter and C equal to minus 50 degree Celsius per meter square. The wall has an area of 10 meter square and thermal conductivity 40 watts per meter Kelvin. The rate of heat transfer in kilowatts at x equal to 0, left end of the wall. So we have to calculate. We have 4 options. The correct answer is 80 kilowatts. The rate of change of energy storage in kilowatt within the wall. What is the amount of energy stored within the wall? So here the answer is, we have 4 options. The answer is 30 kilowatt. So we have the answer here. So we will calculate how the answers are arrived. So how, in the next slide. So this is the wall. So wall of length L, and there is heat generation 10 kilowatts per meter cube. So other parameter, L equal to 1 meter. The area equal to 10 meter square. K thermal conductivity is 40 watts per meter Kelvin. The temperature distribution given as T equal to A plus BX plus CX square, we have A, B, C constant values are also given. Now heat transfer at X equal to 0. So this is minus Q equal to minus KA into DT by DX. So we differentiate this equation. DT by DX equal to B plus 2C into X. DT by DX at X equal to 0 equal to minus 200. We differentiate again. D square T by DX square equal to 2C. So again, D square T by DX square at X equal to 0 equal to 2 into minus 50 equal to minus 100. So dt by dx at x equal to 0 equal to minus 200. D square t by dx square at x equal to 0 equal to minus 100. Now we calculate the heat transfer. So q equal to minus 40 into 10 into minus 200 equal to 80,000, which is 80 kilowatt. That is the answer. Amount of heat transfer from the left surface where x equal to 0 is 80 kilowatts. Then one dimensional unsteady state heat conduction equation with the heat generation. So we write the governing equation K into dou square T by dou X square plus QG heat generator equal to rho C into dou T by dou T. So K into dou square T by dou X square plus QG equal to, right hand side is energy stored within the slab. So energy stored equal to substitute K equal to 40 dou square T by dou X square minus 100 plus QG equal to 10,000. 10 kilowatts, 10,000 divided by the area, 10 meter square. So this is going to be minus 30,000 equal to minus 30 kilowatts. The amount of stored equal to minus 30 kilowatts. That is the answer to the problem. So we stop here. So these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject. There is one book, Heat and Mass Transfer. You can refer to it for additional information. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here in the YouTube channel. And the solution for the gate question paper is also uploaded in the YouTube channel. Refer to the channel for the better preparation and pass in the gate examination. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments. Subscribe the channel for additional videos. And you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. Thank you. We'll meet again in another video lecture on solution on gate question papers.